Hey guys, it's Jim. Of course, we're here with Jonathan Butler-Duplessis, aka the Macy's store manager and our production of Elf the Musical. So man, let's talk a little bit about your time growing up in Champaign and how you decided to get into all this kind of stuff.
Well, let's see. There's this wonderful lady that my grandma used to babysit for. And she actually, my grandma would take me over there and we'd all hang out and I would play with her kids. And she saw me and her daughter act out the ends of Disney movies. It was Aladdin at the time, and I was playing the genie, and she was playing a little Aladdin. I was like, oh no, we gotta move it here, and we're gonna do it like this. Like, you're not doing it right, you gotta. and then she put me in my first play, which was the Scottish play in Champaign. And then I just did a run of musical theater. A run of community theater while I was there. A lot of musicals, but lots of Shakespeare, lots of different things. And then it all kind of just ended because there's not a whole lot of theater to do in Champaign.
Right.
But, you know, so it just kind of ended for a while. And then one day in high school, I followed a really, 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 really cute girl. A really, 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 really cute girl in a drama club. And I just kind of stayed. Like, I wish I had something really profound to say about that, but nah, I just followed a really cute girl.
Well, obviously, the really cute girl in the long run didn't work out, but
did not work out.
I pretty much think this career of yours that
it's
you
a
followed,
good trade.
Yeah, it turned out to be really good for you. You ended up then going to University of Illinois, right?
Mm-hmm. I went to the University of Illinois. I actually bounced around for a little bit. I went to Parkland College and worked on my associates. Then I went off to Springfield and actually got close to getting a ministry degree. I'm actually like three classes away from being ordained.
Of course, because that seems like a natural progression for
right.
any kind of actor.
Theater
right?
to ministry, back to theater.
Right.
And then I came back to the U of I and completed my acting training. I have a BFA in acting. And it's such a wonderful program. I didn't do a lot of musical theater there. It's more classical acting, so it was all the heavy stuff, Shakespeare and Simon and, you know, Moliere and all the great stuff, you know. But, and then after that they said, go forth and try to make this acting thing work for you. I did an internship at Milwaukee Repertory Theater where I got my first professional start.
Which is an absolutely amazing theater company, man.
It's a great.
That's a nice start for you, by the way, to be at Milwaukee Rep.
It's good training, too. They showed me exactly what a professional actor is, how he's supposed to conduct himself. And then they said, okay, your student loans are due. Go! So, yeah.
And ever since then, I mean, you've worked, you know, for us, you've been in Mermaid and Christmas Story, Tommy, Heights, and Hair, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And then after that, you've worked all over the place in every imaginable theater in the Chicagoland area. And you've done all sorts of great plays, Dreamgirls and Color Purple, Sister Act, Merchant of Venice. And this year, or last year, you did Parade at Writers Theater. Mm-hmm. And Writers Theater, one of the most amazing theaters in the Chicagoland area. And you also were nominated for a Jeff Award.
Yes.
And you won the Jeff Award for that, which, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
We were all there this year at the Jeffs. And I will tell you, you gave the coolest, most energetic speech, and really cool speeches that night. But, like, you gave the most coolest, energetic speech of anybody.
Oh, thank
so
you, man.
So what was it like to be nominated? What was it like to get your name called and then to stand on that stage and everybody just went nuts over the whole thing?
Man, well, to be nominated, it was that's, you know, that's kind of all I ever really wanted. Like I talked about, you know, working in this community, there's so many people that come and go and get to be a part of it and have a run of a year or 2 years or two shows. It's every show you're in, you're blessed to be in, and you just want to do something that you feel mattered beyond the time you did it. And that's what was so touching about being nominated. I was actually nominated for Parade and for Little Mermaid, so I was nominated against myself.
Right, yeah.
And I used that to like talk myself, like, you know, there's no way I could win. The honor is just being nominated, so let me just enjoy this. I had a great year. I got to perform all over in places I love, so let's just enjoy that. And I had my grandma there, my auntie there, my girlfriend was there, so we're just all there just to enjoy the night. And enjoy, like, yeah, my name will pop up and everyone will go, golf claps. And then they called my name and I kind of freaked out for a second. I really did not expect that. I watched a lot of pro wrestling growing up and it felt like I was at WrestleMania.
Right.
Wow. Like the music hit and like they're playing these drums and I spaz out for a second. I kiss my girlfriend. I hug my grandma and I run to the aisle. Like if I don't get down there, they're gonna change their mind. and this is where it got really emotional. I look down the aisle and everyone around it is so excited for me. And I didn't know that I had friends like that, you know? Like, I love the people I work with. I absolutely adore them. But, like, I didn't know that we were connected like that. And that meant so much. Like, that's actually the award. Like, you know, the award's with my grandma somewhere. But, like, but being embraced by the community is been my dream. I'm so proud to be a Chicago actor. I don't know where I'll act for the rest of my life, but my time here is like I'm Chi-Town till I die. If I sign a Broadway contract, it's gonna be in a Bulls hat. Like, but it meant so much to be a part of that kind of community. And the thing that meant the most about that for me is like in any other industry, you may get there, you know, because you got your hot stuff. You got talent, you got a good look. Like, that's not how it works in Chicago. You really gotta, it is a workman's environment.
Right.
You gotta earn the respect of your peers and your producers and your directors, and they're there to see you work. And you can't steal one of these, you know what I mean? So it was a validation for just trying to do things the right way. You know, going to college and paying attention to my veteran actors and learning from them. Like, why do you do any of that? That's why.
Well, I gotta tell you, as somebody sat in the audience when your name was called for that, and you know, Paramount, we showed up in masses,
yeah,
in the
buddy.
Paramount Nation, but everybody, because it's a family here and you're a big part of our family, like everybody from the Paramount was absolutely thrilled and filled with joy that you won it. And it would have been great if it was Mermaid, but I mean, even though it's you and you winning for Parade and you're a part of what we do here and a big part of what we do. So it was great to see that happen for you, man. I was wondering though, was it the internal fight of Jonathan who was up for Mermaids? Like, that hack never should have won that for Parade. And then I should have won that. You got to be kidding me. And then stamps out the place and then
Sebastian
comes back into.
Sebastian was mad. He was like, I will not believe you are in any way superior to me. Get out of here.
Well, look, man, it is always fun to hang out with you, and especially during the holidays. So everybody, come see Jonathan and his wonderful castmates. We're
Please.
Going through January 7th. And congratulations on the Jeff and on all the successes that you've had here and in the future, because you're a talented cat, man.
Many
Ladies and
more.
Gentlemen, Jonathan Butler-Duplessis.